In this part, we will have more advanced operations like adding 3D surface or other road decorations to make this road network look more realistic. Now, I would like to add a 3D surface. On the side menu bar, we find 3D surface here. Left click and press, then we see all options. I would like to start with an elevation profile. We select it and click link to. Now we can see link to is selected and highlighted. We can click 2 times to define the start point and the end point. Or we go to the parameters directly to edit the list of points. For more accurate, I would like to define the elevation profile from the start point to the end point. The offset to end point should be 0. And the height changes from 0 to 20 meters. Press enter on keyboard. Now we can see the cross section got changed accordingly. Now let's add a beam on the parking area. Also on the side menu bar, we find this option bump. Left click and press, then we see beam. After selecting beam, we can easily click any point near the parking area, and then we enter parameters and edit it continually. For the start offset, we give it 300 meters far away from the start point of link 0. For the lateral offset, firstly we need to define which line is referring to. The line 0 on the right side is exactly the driving line that we defined before. And now we give the lateral offset 0 meter. We can see it's located on the central of the driving line. The width of the beam should be same as the driving line, 3.5 meter. Of course, don't forget the height. We give it 0.1 meter. The next step is to add some material. In our product examples, we can find many materials and the texture and the ground. There is one PNG file called Sleeping Policeman. We choose this one. Now we can do the 3D preview again to check what we just added on this road network. We can see MoonX is opened right now. Moving forward. Here we can see this is the beam we just placed. Also, the elevation profile on link 2. If we put a beam here, then it also makes sense to set a speed limit here. Also on the set menu bar and the traffic, we find marker, click and press. Then we see different traffic markers we can put. We choose this one, driver speed. Same operation. We click any point before the beam and then we edit parameters. Let's set it 5 meters before the beam. Also, we define the driver speed should not be faster than 10 kilometers per hour. Now, we can set the second marker. This marker will be the end of the speed limit zone. So, speed limit, we choose end and make it located at the end position of the driving area. Now, I would like to add a traffic light at the junction area. Similarly, we click marker and we find driver stop. Click any point before the junction arm. Then, we change the stop marker type into traffic light. The most important thing, a traffic light marker should always be used with a traffic light controller together. There are some parameters we can define in the traffic light controller. For example, we change the initial phase into red to make sure the ego vehicle meets a red light signal when it arrives the junction area. We give it a longer red phase, for example, half minute. For better visualization, we can also add a traffic light and accessories. And define this traffic light with the same controller. It controls the street and right directions. Pay attention, the traffic light and the traffic signs and the accessories can only be recognized by the sensors, but not IPG driver. If we want to IPG driver follow the traffic light signals, like I explained, a traffic light marker and controller are necessary. We will continue optimizing this road network, like adding some road markings in the junction area and parking area. Also, adding the tree strips and generating the terrain. After we click in road marking and move our mouse in the junction area, we can see some driving lines are pre-selected. Just easily single click and choose the junction link 0. Like before, two clicks define the start and the end point. Then we added parameter in the parameter list. 0 meters from the start point, 0 meters from the end point. Now we can see a new broken line is drawing. We can also change the line tools here from single line, broken line, dotted line. Also change the parameters of the broken line to change its appearance. Now let's move to the parking area. We need to draw some parking lots in this area. There are different options. For one or two parking lots, we can easily use the point list to draw the lines like this. Double click to finish. But apparently, there are lots of parking lots need to be drawn, so we use another shortcut. We choose route marking again. Then we draw a broken line here. Define the start offset and the end offset. And we change the parameter of the broken line. We make the dash lines smaller and the width longer. Also change the lateral offset to move it. Now we can see it looks perfectly. The next step is to add tree strips. Just easily click any two points on the road. Then we can see a new tree strip is added here. Of course, we can always edit parameters to define the start and the end point. I would like to make it longer. Also, the road trips will follow the shape of the road. Now, I would like to generate a terrain and start simulation. When we double click terrain here, we can enter the parameters easily. There are different presets, hilly, flight, mountains, and some parameters we can change according to the user's requirement. For example, the height range from 20 to 0, and we easily click generate. We can see the terrain is generated. The file name of the object file is the same as the road file. Now let's switch to the manual settings. IPG company car is pre-selected. Pay attention to the route, which route is defined here. Also, same like before, we gave it a simple manual by limiting the driving time. Now, we can start simulation from MoonX side. Click start. We can see it arrives the speed limit zone, 10 kilometers per hour as we defined. After this zone, IPG driver will speed up. After the red light, continue speeding up. Until the end of the route.